Hi guys, it is another week again. So, as you can probably see from the title, this week I am going to be talking about my guinea pigs. Now, before I start this video, I'm not an expert on guinea pigs, I'm not an expert about animals. These are just some of the tips that I've learned over having them over the last few months. So please don't write in the comments. Oh no, that's not right. It's just what I know and it's just what I do. So then, just stay in that point. So I'm going to talk it in like categories. So first I'm going to talk about the food I give them. Then I'm going to talk about the types of bedding I put in for them and how I do their bedding and how I recreate everything and what toys I put in for them, what treats I give them. You probably saw in last week's vlog that I actually did show you what I bought for them, but I thought I'd show you again in a bit more detail. I will get the guinea pigs out at the end. They are quite difficult to get out because they kind of scratch issue. Some of you guys may know. So let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is basically their bedding. I've got it all on my phone because I wrote it all down on my phone because I knew I'd forget. So I'm going to talk about their bedding. So I'd say in my, because I work quite a lot, I get days off in the week, which is very handy. So I'd say clean the cage out every other day, or obviously if you can, clean the cage out every day, because the cage gets quite messy in the space of 20 minutes, because as soon as I do the cage, it's just like poo, wee everywhere, it's a complete mess. But obviously you can't do it every 20 minutes because that would be stupid. So I normally tend to do it every other day, and if I haven't got time, at least do it three times a week, because the cage gets so messy and there's poo everywhere and there's wee everywhere and there's food everywhere, so it needs to be cleaned out. And because guinea pigs are quite small animals and it's quite disgusting from sitting there and urine. The next thing I'm going to be talking about is obviously the bedding. So some people prefer to use sawdust. I don't. I'll show you what I use. So I use this type of paper. Now this is kind of like newspaper, but obviously it's got no letters on it. But newspaper and kind of this paper would be good because it's good for their claws, because their claws are quite sharp. And they need some to scratch on, and I feel like if you use sawdust, and also when my mum went to go and pick them up from the animal shelter, they did say if they have sawdust it gets in their eyes and it gets up their nose and it's really bad for their eyesight. So I was thinking, I don't want to use sawdust, so I thought I'd use towels. That was a big mistake, because some people do say with towels, because most people don't have their washing machines on a high heat anymore, and because urine is quite a strong smell, it's hard to get out of materials like towels. So I stopped using the towels, and also their claws get stuck, and obviously it's cotton so it gets stuck. So I thought I'd start using paper. It works much better for them. They can play around with it as well, which is good. So I lay that out. So obviously, like how I do it, I get them out of the cage and I put them in the basket, the cage, obviously the handle, the thing that they gave them to me in. Take them out of the cage, because obviously it's better for them to be out of the cage, because then I can clean it up properly. I grab all the paper, put it in, obviously in a bin bag, and then I sweep up all of the poo and all that. I spray. I'll show you the spray. The spray I use is the Clean and Safe Johnson's new improved formula for safe for animals. So this is completely safe for small animals. You can spray this in the cage, and it's disinfectant, cleaner, deodorant. It kills bacteria and viruses where pets live, feed, sleep and feed. So this is really good stuff. So after I've got all the poo out and I've cleaned all the cage out, I spray this on the cage, and then I let it sit for a few minutes, and then I wipe it up, and it wipes all like the kind of bacteria that was on the cage. And then after that, I use the Cage cleaning wipes, which is convenient, fast and hygienic. It kills 99.9% of bacteria. It formulates for use around pets and eliminates odours and freshness. So because the cage does smell of urine half the time, it needs to be cleaned out, and obviously the smell is very nice. And you don't put perfume scents in the cage because it's too bad for their like insides and their nose. So I got these from Pets at Home. Obviously I trust Pets at Home and any pet shop, but these are the cage wipes I bought, and you obviously use the Greens Clean and Safe spray. So I use that, and then I put the paper on top, and then I'll insert a picture now on what I make the cage to look like. And then when I put the tunnel, they have three tunnels, they have, I think you'll see them. So it's a green one, like a fluffy one, a blue and purple one, which is obviously vegetarian friendly because they are vegetarian, they don't eat any sort of meat. I will talk about that later. So they can nibble on it and scratch on it, which is really good for them. And then I buy a hay tunnel every 1 to 2 months because they scratch on it, it's got hay on it, it can nibble on everything. And then I put straw down. This is the straw I have been using at the moment. So I got this from Pets Hunt, and if you have any Pets Hunts near you, I thought just it was good for the price. So it's $2.99, as it says on the packaging, and it comes in quite a big bag. And you don't particularly need a lot of straw; you just need a little bit to cover the cage up, so they can. It's just nice for them to sit on. And this comes in a big bag, obviously straw, ideal for rabbits, guinea pigs, pets, pet mice and all small animals. So this is obviously good for my guinea pigs. So I put that down for them. I'll just put another picture now to what the cage actually should look like. But no, that is the bedding. We are next going to talk about food. I'll talk about food this time. Now I'm going to talk about food. So the food, I'll show you some of the food that I give them. So every morning I go in their cage, and obviously I was using muesli, but then I thought I'd switch up a bit because I like to switch up the diet a bit. So obviously every morning you try and change the water at least twice a day. I give them a bowl of clean water. Normally people have the sucky thing, I can't remember what it's called. But obviously I haven't got holder for it, so I've managed to do a bowl and they just like climb over it and do that. So that's worked for me. And also came with the cage is a hole where I put their food. So normally I try to give them fresh vegetables. I don't give them fruit because I feel it'd be too slimy for them. So today I gave them celery, and I chop it up, and then I put some in the bowl, and then I put some around the cage so they can find it, so they get a bit of exercise, because with guinea pigs they don't really exercise that much, they just sit in the cage. And then this week I got this from Tesco's. Obviously with vegetables you can get them in any supermarket, but I got this from Tesco's, and I've been using it only I think yesterday and today. So this is guinea pig nuggets that I use, and they really seem to like them at the moment. I mean, I do try and mix up every time I run out of food. I go and see if I can find something else. The obviously, you know, not a really nice smell, but the guinea pigs love it. I know it's guinea pig friendly because it says guinea pig food on it. And also it says on the back, it says Tesco guinea pig nuggets, a complimentary feed for guinea pigs enriched with vitamins and specially formulated to help prevent and selective feeding. It has vitamin E to help support any healthy immune system. With 17% fiber, it's no added sugar, enriched with vitamins including vitamin C and minerals, and balanced levels of calcium and prosperive to help maintain healthy teeth and bones. So it helps with their teeth and bones as well, which is good. So I give them, you only need a handful, because guinea pigs, otherwise, the thing is with guinea pigs, if you give them too much food, they'll just get really fat, and then they'll they'll get too fat and they'll be really unhealthy. So you only need to give them a handful of food each morning, and then I've used 2 celery sticks and I've chopped them up and then I just put it around the cage and in the bowl. I then also put, I got one of the hays I got over there, so I'm still using that one, but I'll show you the one I will be using. Obviously all hay is kind of the same anyway, but this is the hay I will be using, and this is basically, they have a little hutch bit on the side of their cage, and I just put loads of hay in there. They need at least three different categories of food to try and mix up their diet and also try and keep them like healthy. Obviously you don't feed them too much, but they need those 3 portions. So they need nuggets, either muesli, fresh vegetables, and they need hay. Those are the 3 major things they need, and they need clean water every day. But that's obviously just what I do. Also, I found these online, and obviously I know what not to feed my guinea pigs, but I thought I'd just give you a few bits if you're wanting to get a guinea pig. So I already know these already, so you shouldn't feed them cereal, grains, nuts, seeds, corn, beans, peas, bread, biscuits, sweets and sugar, and chocolate is basically any human food you should not feed them, because it's very, very unhealthy for them and they could be poisoned basically. I wouldn't feed them any kind of onion grass, onions, potatoes, raw beans, beetroot, spinach, rhubarb leaves, pickled food for any bulk animals. So basically don't feed them spinach. I think that's the reasoning why, because it's very, very strong. And also I wouldn't feed them beetroot anyway. And I wouldn't feed them onions, because onions is very, and for their eyes, because onions is very strong smell, and even for humans' eyes, it's when you're chopping an onion up, obviously, you know, that your eyes go all like steamy up. So I don't think it'd be good for them anyway. But I don't feed them those type of foods anyway, so I only feed them like celery. Sometimes I give them a big, you know, big bulks of broccoli, so I give them that, carrots. Cucumber is also the good thing I give them, but I give them like varieties of what I think that they'd like. Obviously when I first got them, I think I was feeding them too much and they got a bit overweight, so I had to downsize their food. But no, that's basically what I feed them. And also, I think I've showed you this last week, but I'll show you anyway. I get different types of treats for them for every week. I don't give them one every day because it would be too much for them. So what I got is the carrot and broccoli sticklets for rabbits, guinea pigs and chinchillas. I obviously have to always make sure that they are guinea pig friendly. I don't want to get them something that's not guinea pig friendly and then I end up killing them or something. So these are the sticklets, carrot and broccoli. I think that's quite convenient. And they have little sticks, so you hook them on the cage so they can like grab up and eat it. Next I have the 2 seed nut and flavoured sticks. Obviously it did say don't feed them nuts, but I think in cases of don't feed them human nuts, like pecan nuts or sesame seed nuts or peanuts, basically. But obviously these are for guinea pigs, and I did get these from Pets at Home, and they're not going to not like feed them something that would be stupid. But no, these this also is to hang from a wire, so obviously they can climb up and get them. And I absolutely love these ones. They've got different types of nuts, guinea pig nuts on for them, so that is amazing. I also picked up guinea pig fruit sticks. So I want them to have fruit, but I don't want them to have like squishy fruit, so I thought I'd get them on a stick. So this is basically surprisingly fruity. Pets at Home, just their range of what they think. And also I won't give them this to them yet because I think it's quite big. I think I'll give them like a special occasion. But this is woodland stuff window bell, so you basically hang the bell from the cage and then they grab up and then there's food underneath here. I think it's really cute. I really did like it. This stuffed willow bell is perfect for guinea pigs, rabbits and rats. So obviously, like I said, I always make sure that they're okay for guinea pigs. I'm not trying to kill my guinea pigs. So that is basically what food substances I give them. I talked about the bedding I did, the food. Also, I'm going to talk about bathing. Now, when I bath them, I haven't bathed them yet because I only say, like I said, I only got them a few months, like a month or 2 months or 1 month or 2 months ago. So basically what they told my mum, and when she went to go and pick them up from the animal shelter, that's the word, animal shelter, they said to her, you only need to bath them 3 times a year. I know that sounds, oh, that's disgusting, but because guinea pigs are so small and they're not like dogs. So, I mean, saying if they did get really mucky and they're outside, yes, obviously you bath them, but they don't need bathing a lot. So when I do eventually bath them, I will show you. Because obviously they're not human, so I wouldn't suggest you use Garnier or Head and Shoulders because they are guinea pigs and not humans. So obviously, yes, this did cost me quite a lot of money. I mean, in a sense, it cost me like £3, but considering they're quite tiny animals and they don't need a lot of shampoo. So this is the Johnson Small Animal Shampoo, cleanses and deodorizes mild and non-irritant. So you put that on their fur and it's not going to irritate them whatsoever. Obviously, you would not use this for guinea pigs who are under 12 weeks because obviously still babies. My guinea pigs are 2 years of age and I think, you know, this is will be convenient for them. So obviously you would not put this in your eyes, try not to put it in their eyes. So you kind of try not, you don't need to cover it in them in shampoo, but just try not get it in their eyes because it will sting their eyes, and also don't get it in your eyes. Don't put the shampoo on your hands and then stick your hands in your eyes because that would be stupid. I'd obviously do it in my bath. Or I'd do it in or outside or something obvious, but you wouldn't have the water too cold and then you wouldn't have the water too hot, so obviously because you don't want to burn them and then you don't want to freeze them to death. So I suggest you brush them every so often. I'm not saying you have to brush them every day, but especially with I think I showed you how with Molly and Minstrel. Minstrel is the boy, so he's short haired, and Molly is the fluff, she's the long head. So they still both need brushing quite a lot. So I went into Pets at Home and I got these brushes. Now there's a certain way you have to use these brushes. So you use the comb first, so you comb through their fur, and then you use this bristle brush, which is obviously gets all the knots out and everything. Also, that's got my hair in it, I don't know why. This is quite a good brush, and I didn't think I should use my own brush because it did contact with my hair and the guinea pig's hair. And then this is the soft brush for to just make their fur all soft. So I got these from Pets at Home. I can't remember how much they were, but I'll try and put these on in the description. I got these deluxe claw trimmer. I haven't trimmed their nails yet, but I think I'm a bit scared to in case I hurt them or something. I tried to do it the other day and it didn't go as planned. So I think I might go to Pets at Home. And if you go to Pets at Home and take your guinea pigs in, rats, whatever animal you have, a small animal, for I think £15, they will trim the nails for you and they will go over if they're unhealthy or if they're overweight and everything. So I think that's really good. But I did buy the deluxe claw trimmer. If you want to have a look at them, I'll try and put them in the link description below. Once you have done their claws, you need to put them back in the packaging because you don't want it to get all like bacteria all over it. The next thing, I think the last thing we're going to talk about is when you take them out the cage, you need to take the out of the cage as much as possible. I wouldn't suggest leaving them in the cage all the time because they would get too attached to the cage and they won't want to come out, and that will make them very sad and very depressed. Now obviously when you hold them, I suggest you put a towel on your lap because with guinea pigs they have no sense of bladder control. and I've learnt this because they eat poo and wee everywhere. Not everywhere, but if you hold them, they poo and wee. They don't know when they're doing it. That's not their fault. They don't know when they're pooing and weeing, so they have no sense of bloody control. So when you hold them, you need either a towel, or when you're holding them like that, you need like a towel or something. Or only if you're holding for a few seconds, but it's just the full fact of you don't want like urine and poo all over your clothes, because it's quite disgusting. I have done that before and it's gone all over the place. Also, I suggest try not to let them on a carpet, because if they wee on the carpet, then you can have urine in your carpet and it's not very nice. So try and do it on a wooden floor, so when they run about or go in a corner, you could easily just swipe up the poo or mop up the urine. So that would be a good idea, because that, I mean, I did that the other day and it was perfect, because I just shut all the doors and in the hallway, I put them out in the hallway and then they could do what they liked. But if you put them on a carpet, then the urine is going to go in the carpet and the carpet is going to smell. So, just thought I'd like give you some friendly advice, just to let you know, just don't put them on a carpet. Just don't, because I've tried it already and it just, no. What else do I need to tell you? And I think that is it. Yeah, I went over the bedding, the food, the washing, how to hold them, and what type of toys I had in the cage for them. Obviously with toys, I don't tend to put toys in, because guinea pigs don't do that much exercise. They say, some people say you can get a running ball for them, but I think that is only for rats and for mice. And for mice and rats, I think, and gerbils, because they're quite athletic. But with guinea pigs, they're not so athletic. They will just, all they do is poo, wee, eat, and sleep. That's all they do all day. So there's no point getting them anything to exercise in, because they won't use it. Obviously with tunnels, yes, that's a good form of exercise, because they're running in and out the holes, which is good, yeah. So that's it from this week's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys got a load of good tips from this video. I'll put everything in the link description below, as much as I can, and the much I remembered from any Pets at Home or Pets Hunt and everything. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you got good tips from this video. Please give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you are new, and press the bell notifications button to know when I upload. Every week I don't do it on the same day or the same time because of my job, so yeah, I'm very sorry about that, and I will see you guys next week. Bye. I forgot to show you guys my guinea pigs. I said I'd show them to you. So this one here, they are so cute. Look at them, aren't they cute? Yes, they are. So, they are Mitsu, and this is Molly. But no, I love them and adore them so much, even if they do like rumble through the cage. And they like to eat my face as well. Look, aren't they cute? But they don't bite. That is another thing I should mention. They don't bite. You hear them. So they make little noises. But that is obviously the one thing I'm going to mention at the end. Guinea pigs don't bite. They are very friendly animals, and that's why they say they're children's animals, because they don't bite. They do kind of scratch, but very rarely. They don't bite unless they're being like abused, or if they get, nothing. They don't even get violent. But they do make noises, which I think is pretty cute. But no, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And please subscribe if you are new, like I said. And please give this a big thumbs up if you liked my guinea pigs. And if you liked my tips on guinea pigs. And I will see you guys next week. Bye! Yeah, it's too cute, aren't you? Not being funny, but... Sorry, baby. You're that naughty. Yeah, I know.
Grace?
Yeah?
Could we go a little earlier so that we can get to... Oh. I need to go to the shop. supermarket. Is that alright?
What time do you want to go?
Look, there, look, look, my little baby.
Yeah, you're getting irritated now. I'll put you back.
Say goodbye. Get a nice zip, would ya?